Good morning, girls. Today we'll be learning Chapter 1.3, Autobiography of Great Indian Bustard. Textbook, page number 6. Let's begin. Let's see what is meant by autobiography. An autobiography is a self-written life story. That means it's an account of a person's life written by the same person. Let's begin. This autobiography is written by Dr. Pramod Patil. Now, Dr. Pramod Patil is an ornithologist. Now, what do you mean by ornithologist? Ornithologist is someone who study every aspect of the birds. Okay? Let's move on. He starts by introducing the bird, saying, "Which is the heaviest flying bird in India?" "Well, friends, it's me, the Great Indian Bustard. I feel proud to be known as the Great Indian Bustard." Let's see Great Indian Bustard. A Great Indian Bustard or Indian Bustard is a bird found on the Indian subcontinent. A large bird with a horizontal body and long bare legs, giving it an ostrich-like appearance. This bird is among the heaviest of the flying birds. He says, "I have more than 30 different names in various Indian languages. In Marathi, I am known as Maldok or Hum. I can weigh up to 18 kilos and can stand up to 4 feet in height, reaching up to your shoulder or even higher. I have a long neck. I have a long white neck, brown wings, tall yellow legs, and a black cap on my head. My wife, Mrs. Bustard, is smaller and slimmer than I am. Her neck is not white, but I have heard humans say that we both look impressive." Now here he has shown the difference between the male and the female Bustard. The female Bustard is smaller and slimmer than the male Bustard, and her neck is not white. But the male Bustard has a white neck. Let's move on. He says, "I live on grassland and desert along with my other friends, including chinkara, blackbuck, and lark." Now, chinkara, blackbuck, and lark are the friends of Great Indian Bustard. He also says, "I like everything to eat, including snakes, lizards, small fruits and berries, and all sort of insects. That is a very healthy habit. But grasshoppers and beetles are my favorite food items." Here, Buster says that he likes to eat everything, including snakes, lizards, small fruits, everything. But from these food items, grasshoppers and beetles are his favorite. He says, "When it starts raining, we all gather at our favorite grassland, where there are no people to disturb us. I perform a wonderful dance by gulping air in a special feathery pouch attached below my neck. This pouch helps me to produce a resonating sound similar to the one produced by the cow. Hum. I dance, enjoy with puff out feathers and cook up tail and drop down wings. It helps me to impress my soulmates." Now here the Great Indian Bustard says that he likes to dance in the rain, just similar to the peacock. Even the peacock likes to dance in the rain, right? Yes. So he says that they all gather at their favorite spot in the grassland and they start dancing over there. They see that there are no people to disturb them. And then, while dancing, they start swallowing the air in the special feathery pouch and start creating a similar sound just produced by the cow, that is, hum. Now here, the word gulping means swallowing, okay? And cook up tail, cook up tail means to raise at right angle. So they raise their tail at right angle. Let's move on. We know that weavers lay eggs and a young ones hatch out of eggs. Mother Great Indian Buster lay just one egg directly on the ground. We don't believe in building nest, but we have a special trick to protect our eggs from predators. Here the Great Indian Buster says that the mother buster lay an egg directly on the ground. They don't need to build their nest. They have a special feature, that is, their eggs looks like a stone. Thus, they don't have to worry about their predators. Therefore, they lay their eggs directly on the ground. The Great Indian Buster says that monitor lizards, fox, dogs, pigs, snakes, and eagles are enemies of my eggs and chicks, that means the young ones. But my wife protects the egg from all of them. By the time a young one hatched out of the egg, rain arrives. There's a plenty of grass swarming with the insects, fresh food for my family. Young ones of other birds soon fly away from the nest. But a Great Indian Buster mother and chicks stay together for nearly 1 year. The chicks learn many good habits from the mother. Now the Great Indian Buster says that you may have heard about a great human friend of ours, that is Dr. Salim Ali. Now, do you know who is Salim Ali? Students, Dr. Salim Ali, he was an Indian ornithologist and naturalist, also referred as Birdman of India. He was the first Indian to conduct a systematic bird survey across India and wrote several bird books that went popular in India. The Great Indian Buster says that Dr. Salim Ali suggested to give the status of the national bird to the Great Indian Buster. But this honor went to the peacock. But still, he is happy to tell you that I am the state bird of Rajasthan. And we have got 10 centuries for our protection, but sadly, our number is still going down. He says, we used to live in all parts of India, but slowly the growing population of man push us away from more than 90% of our home regions. We are afraid of hunters that kill us for fun. We also die due to electric power lines that we can't see while flying. We are losing our homes. Today, only the last 200 of us are left in the world. We need your support and love in order to survive. Can you help? You can write letters to your leaders and make an appeal to help us. You can make my drawings and submit it to your teachers. You can discuss this with your parents. Come to see us at centuries, because now you will not see us in any other places. And who knows, if humans don't help us, none of us will be left on the earth. You will only see us in pictures. With this, we have completed our today's chapter, that is, Autobiography of a Great Indian Buster. Thank you.